Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the Soviet IL-2 1941 sitting at 2.3 battle rating in the USSR-3. Fantastic attacker. This thing, of course, world famous. Another game has been named after this thing. And it is a magnificent attacker. Really fun to play. Has a turn rate, sustained turn rate, that is absolutely surprising for such an armored beast. It's a tank in the sky. And, well, of course, it's not very fantastic in the vertical. But in the turn rate, you can surprise so many people. It is fun. You get an air start. And it has fantastic guns. It has a great setup for the early game. And, of course, a great combination of rockets and bombs and all that. Yes, let's get into the details of this IL-2. The maximum speed in this plane at sea level without web is 398 kilometers an hour and with web 420. At 4500 meters, this is 337 without web and 344 with. And finally, at 6500 meters, this is 280 without web and 290 with. Now, these speeds are in indicated airspeed without mech. How is this plane in the dive? Well, not fantastic, to be honest. The top speed in the dive is 589 kilometers an hour before she redlines and 650 before she rips apart. That means there is only about 61 kilometers an hour between the red line and the moment where she rips apart, and this is tricky. That is a small window, and those small window planes, the planes that do have this, are dangerous in a dive. As you are in the lower ends of your dive, coming close to 600, you already, within a few seconds, you will rip apart, as you are picking up speed rapidly at that point. So you basically want to keep it at about 550 when you want to roll out of a dive and get yourself straightened out for that plane, because otherwise you will rip. The control stiffening in the plane, is it the effective dive speed at 600-ish speed? No, it's not. The 400 kilometers an hour, you get the first big compression tick, especially in the roll rate. Elevator stays functional up until the end, to be honest. And the 550, it becomes very severe, so it's impossible to get guns on target, and it also becomes tricky to roll out of a dive because it becomes very compressed at that point. So yeah, before 550, you really want to start rolling out of dive, to be honest. The stall speed in the plane is 140 kilometers an hour, which is actually decent for this plane. Good engine, but very heavy frame with all the armor protection for the pilot and the gunner. Now here we come to the firepower. This plane has great firepower for this battle rating, 2.3 battle rating. You get two 20mm Schwak cannons with 210 rounds per gun, and that is supported by two 7.62mm SCUS machine guns with 750 rounds per gun. Now, I used ground targets for the 20mm and universal for the smaller calibers, a 600m convergence. That's my regular setup. The plane is also equipable with a loadout of bombs or rockets or a combination of the both. It has more than one page. There's lots of options, and yeah, you can take your pick on what you want to take with you. The ammo loads on this plane are excellent. Really nice ammo loads on the 20mm at this stage. Most early 20mm carrying planes have 60 rounds, and this thing has 210 rounds per gun. That's your regular later game loadout for 20mm ammo, and it's fantastic in this plane. So you are far from harmless or a sitting duck or anything. Of course, the boom and zooming planes will get the shot on you. You do not have a gunner on this plane, but all in all, this plane has great defense in it, forward facing guns, and it has a trick up its sleeve with the sustained turn rate, which is really, really good in this plane. Let's look at the performance a little bit. The acceleration in a straight line, well, that is below average. It takes quite a bit to wind this plane up and get her up to speed if you're slow. In a dive, the acceleration is actually good, but not initially. So you start off at average in a dive, but the weight of the plane does come into the calculation here. And at a certain point, you start to speed it up and you get good acceleration for a long time in your dive. Of course, the dive cannot be too long because it has the the reasonably early red line and then the quick rip speed coming right after that. Energy retention in the plane, in the horizontal, is decent, and in the vertical it's bad. So if you're coming out of a dive and you keep her in a straight line with web, you have some decent energy retention there. But in the vertical, when you're going into vertical maneuvers, you get very bad energy. You lose a lot of speed in the vertical. So this is definitely something that you want to avoid. You want to keep this plane, if you are in a pickle, you want to keep it in straight turn fighting in the horizontal. Don't go into the vertical too much because you lose a lot of speed. And when it becomes slow, this plane is also a bit sluggish. So you want to avoid that. Keep the speed up with web in horizontal turns, and you can dominate a lot of planes. You can compete with some of the Spitfires even, which is it's very interesting. Deploy the flaps and surprise a few Spitfire pilots here and there. That is amazing in this plane. The climb rate is only average though, and you do get an air start, of course, but as you see here, we got outclimbed by your regular P40s and stuff like that, which are not really special planes when it comes to climb rate. Of course, the Kai 44 is not a surprise that thing is above us, but the P40s don't have great climb rate either, and they don't get an air spawn, so it says something about the climb rate of the IL-2 that you cannot outclimb a P40 in the end. Unfortunately, we didn't get the kill there, that E-44. But yeah, the plane shines in the turn time. Here we come to the turn time, which is quite decent without the flaps, but it's good and even very good at some speeds. Coming between 300 and 450, this plane has some very nice turn times with flaps. The flaps only rip off at 500 kilometers an hour, and that is actually nice. It lays far above the regular cruising speeds of this plane. Only in a dive can you rip off the flaps, so you can use them pretty indiscriminately. The only thing is, once fully extended, those flaps can start to become a little bit like air brakes and slow you down. And if you become too slow, well, then you become a little bit more sluggish again as well. So you really have to manage the flaps. The flaps usage on this plane is a little bit of a fine-tuned art. And you want to open them, you want to take advantage of them, and then you want to close them again before they can fully extend. Because when they fully extend, well, then you get that problematic state. So you don't want to keep them deployed at all times when you are in a dogfight, as it does slow you down a lot. Roll rate in the plane is below average. Of course, you can imagine with all that ammo loads, with all the armor, the plane is a little bit sluggish when it comes to that. And you notice that in the roll rate and at the slow speeds. And of course in the vertical. But yeah, the roll rate below average, that makes the overall maneuverability decent. And that is quite surprising for such a plane, right? And for the use it has. And but it's fantastic because you are not immediately dead when somebody comes for you when you're ground pounding. And I have surprised many a plane. I'm running fantastic kill death ratio scores and ground target scores on this plane for the amounts of deaths that I got. So I really like this plane. And I can even imagine once you start to specialize in a plane like this, you will become, a very difficult opponent to take down, because it can take a shit ton of damage as well. The durability in this plane is freaking fantastic. It just won't die, this plane. It can take a shit ton of damage and still take you home. That is fantastic. Overheating in the plane is present, but it is definitely manageable. So yeah, man, this plane, close air support, attacker, support fighter, And to be honest, it can even be used as a fighter. You can even say it's a fighter, because in a dogfight, you don't necessarily have to lose if you keep to the rules in this plane. And those rules are: keep it turning in the horizontal, get planes in front of you, and use the guns to devastating effect. Don't go into the vertical too much. Keep an eye on your speed and use the flaps conservatively. But when you use them, they can really help you in overcoming even specialized turn fighters, which is absolutely fantastic. This plane has so much tricks up its sleeve and is so surprisingly good that I was so pleasantly surprised by this. It was stock, I never flew it in RB, but it is an absolute baller. This is a fantastic plane, and I'm loving it. I'm loving it. I would love to stay there and fly this plane out more, but I can't. I've got other planes to review, and we gotta move on to the next one, as I'm working on rank 2 for the Soviets right now, getting footage. I'm also going for rank 6 Sweden. Rank 1 Soviets is on the way. I've got all the footage and all the data lined up. I'm gonna make the sound hopefully today, and it will arrive somewhere, hopefully before this weekend, maybe on Friday, maybe Thursday. We'll see how the time comes to me. If I have the time, I will put it out in the coming days, and you will then after that see rank 6 Sweden and rank 2 Soviets, which is a fantastic joy so far. To be honest, this was a fantastic plane to fly. Here we go. We also, that 4-kill match with 2 AI planes got me 6 kills in that. 48,000 Silver Lions and 7,000 research points. We've got Terror of the Sky and Bulletproof and a lot of joy. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. Now, the IL-2 is a fantastic plane and one of the best attackers that I've played so far. It has fantastic forward-facing gun with a lot of ammo. The firepower is great, ammo load is excellent, you have bombs and rocket options and combos. You can put on the plane to your heart's content what you want and what you want to do. It has very good sustained turn rate with flaps, and that is surprisingly good. You can surprise Spitfires and other turn fighters with it and get your guns on them and just evaporate them. Also, it's very durable, it's absolutely fan-freaking-tastic. Just won't die, and it is very valid in a close air support role, attacker role, support fighter, and even a fighter role if you want that. And go out clean without any bombs or rockets, and just keep climbing from altitude and then work it as a fighter. I think even that is viable. You can have a lot of fun thus. It's a very versatile plane that can give you a lot of joy and happiness. And that's what it's all about. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.